Good evening, everyone. My name is Abhay. I'm from CMRIT in Bangalore. I have two other fellows here from my college, Asher, John Satya, and Priyanka Srivastava. Hey, Priyanka. Yeah. So we became fellows in 2016. I'm here to talk about how we disrupt rigid systems. When we belong to college, CMRIT, we find the administration pretty ambitious and aggressive with how they implement their innovation and entrepreneurship policies. But the one constraint that we were having was that we were affiliated to VTU. VTU is a system that that has rigid attendance rules, rigid rules for marks, rigid rules for course credits, and so many other things. And despite having a progressive management, we because of political, legal, environmental constraints, we sort of ended up being a college with a traditional Indian education system. All of this started changing when Asher, Priyanka, and I became selected as University Innovation Fellows. We started working on the two crucial components that we felt were important to the college ecosystem. One was the makerspace and one was the incubation center. Through the makerspace, we were able to organize a lot of design thinking workshops and business plan competitions. We got to MOUs signed, and we got a lot of funding for workshops, projects, and competitions. And these competitions actually paid out money to students who won. So this was not just organized with the students, it was organized with the help of alumni who liked what we presented during our stakeholder meeting that we presented to our faculty. And the incubation center, which was dormant for quite some time, received a lot of support in terms of tie-ups with other training institutes that the college is now rolling out to the upcoming batch from next year onwards. So this was all before the college decided to do something that we find was extremely important to how we could shape our education system. They decided to apply for autonomy from the VTU system. I like to describe this as breaking some chains that VTU otherwise had us operating under. And now we could do so much with what we had. We could decide how attendance was allotted. We could decide how course credit was allotted. We could decide how marks were given. And the only catch was that the incoming batch of freshmen would get those benefits. So Asher, Priyanka, and I will not get them. But in the words of the wise Albus Dumbledore, it's for the greater good. The college also promoted a few startups using their PR might. So my startup and a friend of mine, Anthony, he has his own startup. And we got into a lot of newspapers owing to how much the college supported us. And they helped sort of spread the word among students. So this created a lot of excitement with students. I've always maintained that the college canteen is an excellent place for innovative discussions. And this sort of continued with renewed vigor because of all of the happening things with our college ecosystem. With the incoming batch of freshmen, we're going to introduce electives in entrepreneurship. The college has a lot of things planned. They now have the freedom to do what they want to do. Now they have the freedom to decide how marks go, how course credit is allotted, how attendance is given. Course credit is given to student entrepreneurs and makers. We find that sitting in a classroom to learn entrepreneurship is not enough. You need to go out and start creating companies. They might fail, they might work. But in the end, you start to learn valuable experiences. Incubation center types within classrooms train students to think in ways that help them financially, in ways that help them solve problems. But they also need to go out and start doing work. And this is where course credit is going to get allotted to them when they're doing work outside. With all this, I want to end with one question. How might you disrupt rigid systems? Thank you very much for your time.